Once again, a referee in charge, Jay Nady, now to give instructions.
Do you have any questions? Okay. Obey my commands. Your trunks both look good. When I tell you to break, I want you to break. Step back. Let's go to work.
All right, we're set to go. Jones, 21-1 in world championship fights. The one world championship fight that he lost was on a disqualification when he hit Montel Griffin when he was down. And in his very next fight, he knocked out Montel Griffin. So you might say this guy is an undefeated champion with a tall, tall order tonight as he moves up to fight the heavyweight champion of the WBA in Johnny Ruiz. Ruiz must pressure, must try to get pressure on Roy Jones. I must say his body looks in phenomenal shape.
Yeah, it looks in good shape.
Here we go, round number one. Bob Sheridan with Lennox Lewis. Johnny Ruiz in the black trunks. We're digging downstairs for Roy Jones. And right on top of him is Johnny Ruiz. Roy walks behind the referee. A nice maneuver to make sure he doesn't get in. Tries to get the left hand in the face of Johnny. Comes right through the jab. And that's a significant fact that Lennox early that even when Roy gets a jab up there, Johnny just goes right through it.
Yeah, he's definitely going on the body attack. He's trying to go after the body right now because he realizes in later rounds, you know, he's going to slow Roy Jones down.
Well, John comes right in with his head down, kind of like the bull. This guy went to what I call, and you did too, the University of Evander Holyfield, a guy that does a lot of things very tough and a very difficult guy to beat, and he survived it.
Definitely. Anytime Ruiz throws a punch, he comes in with that head, ducks it down low.
Jones throws a wide shot that catches Ruiz high, but it's obvious that Johnny Ruiz, who has said that he is going to keep pressure on Roy Jones, is doing exactly that in the early going. Roy does show his hand speed early here, and it brings the crowd to life. Johnny waits now, tries to get out with that jab. He wants to land that jab in the face, and he does, doubling it, and then throws the right hand to the body of Jones. Jones comes back, and they're tied up again. This is just round one, it's scheduled for 12. Roy Jones Jr. facing you in the brown trunk with the Jones Jr. on him. That's Johnny Ruiz with his back to you. Jones waits, and so does Ruiz. They're right in the center of the ring. Jones loads up the right hand, catches Johnny, but it has no effect on him.
This round, they're just feeling each other out. It's a cat and mouse game, seeing what they can work, different combination punches.
It's clear to me that there's a significant amount of power by the heavyweight Ruiz because, I mean, he just stepped up with what looked like a light left jab and it put Jones back on his heels. But Roy does show significant and considerably more hand speed than, of course, John Ruiz.
Definitely doesn't want to get hit.
Don't forget, Ruiz has 7.5 inches in reach and at least 30 pounds in weight advantage here in this fight. Jones does get to the body, but John did too. So as Lennox says, a feeling out for the first round, but it's obvious that Ruiz is going to try and keep the pressure on Roy Jones throughout the course of this fight, although he's waiting a lot, too. Right back comes Johnny after he's hit. Jones stops the power.
Oh.
Back he goes at his heels. He loads up a right hand of the goal, and Johnny wants no part of it as he bangs him with a left hook. Jones comes back and catches Ruiz with the right hand, but it had no effect. 12 seconds to go in the first round. Inside of 5 seconds to go in the first round. Johnny waiting. Now he goes to the jab. Blows up the right hand. Windmills past the ear of Ruiz. I think Ruiz won the first round.
Yeah, very close round. Very close round.
The only thing I thought there was more power. That's the only difference in the feeling out round.
Oh, yeah.
Take deep breath. Deep breath.
Alan Merkus to talking to Roy.
Give me some more feint. Give me some more feint. You're moving straight back on me a little bit. Circle off when you're moving out. Okay? Circle out. Don't move straight back.
Lennox?
Oh, yeah. Here's Johnny coming in with a body attack. He threw him with a right hand. It looked like it hurt him.
Nice. This is Roy answering back.
Yeah, definitely. He answered back good.
But the significant thing there in those two replays, again, the power of the right-handed Ruiz looked like it took more effect on Jones than what looked like a flush right hand to the side of the head of Ruiz, and Ruiz just gobbled it up.
Oh, yeah. If Ruiz hits Roy Jones with a good punch, Roy will go down.
All right, here we go. Round number two, scheduled for 12. The WBA heavyweight champion is Johnny Ruiz. the magnificently talented Roy Jones Jr., the undisputed light heavyweight champion, trying to do what no light heavyweight has done since Michael Spinks, who admittedly beat an aged Larry Holmes when he won the title ever so closely, too. A lot of people thought that Larry Holmes won that fight, but the first round sort of feeling out. We've seen the power of Johnny Ruiz in the first round. Johnny waiting now, a little bit more than his corner wants him to wait. Waits again, he wants to double and triple that jab. What he's trying to do, he's not waiting, he's trying to sucker Jones in and down. Trying to time a right hand with Jones coming in. Jones is really slick and very smart in the ring, so I don't think he'd be fooled by those tactics, but that's what Jones is trying to do. It's not that he's waiting to get off. When he goes after him definitively with a left jab in the face two and three and four times. He's trying to trap Jones in. Jones is a guy who likes to set traps himself, Lennox, by waiting and looking for the opportunity to land the big blow.
And that's what he's doing. He's basically waiting for Johnny to commit himself and then take advantage of it, especially with that left uppercut, because he knows he puts his head down.
And that's the proper fight plan, too, for him, to try and catch him off. If John does put his head down, he gets it, unable to land the shot. But Roy has got to do something more if he's going to take these rounds. Waiting, waiting. It's a a game of chess.
I'm looking at Roy Jones like a snake. You know, he's ready to pounce, and Johnny's ready to pounce like a lion. He's waiting for their opportunity.
Roy hanging that left hand down by his hip. Johnny comes in. Johnny needs to throw a right hand to get his attention. Roy feels like he's got the hand speed to counter him should he throw the right hand first and throw a pretty good right hand himself right back at John. But as we saw in the first round, the right hand didn't seem to have the power. Here's Roy trying to take the round now. Both guys need to do something to take this round in the last minute of this second round. Ruiz is not keeping the pressure on in the second round that he did in the first round.
It seems like they both want a counterpunch. Both waiting.
Roy opens up first and explodes, and Johnny just ties him up with about 32 seconds to go in the second round. Ruiz to the right of the screen. Gets that jab in the face of Roy Jones Jr. Roy throws him with an uppercut. And you see Ruiz wants to muscle him and throw him around. And referee Jay Nady right on top of that. About 15 seconds to go in the second round. Not a pretty round. It's a chess match in the second round. And again, a very close second round. Who do you give this one to?
I say it's even.
A nice stiff left jab right at the end. And just that, if that was a dead even round, might be enough to give it to the judges, because John Ruiz scored two stiff punches at the end of the round. And based on that, knowing that these judges, namely Dwayne Ford, Jerry Roth, and Stanley
Casanova,
won't score even rounds, so we listen in.
Give him another water bottle. Him. That's good. That's good. Don't let him keep his feet still.
Watch the left hand here by Ruiz to the body. This time Roy misses two wild shots. No desperation by either guy, Lennox.
Not yet. I think Roy's waiting for the later rounds to really begin an attack. He's just trying to figure him out right now.
Gabe LaMarca whispered in the ear of Johnny Ruiz, come on, Johnny, keep the pressure on him. We want to make this a pressure fight. Both guys off their stool, and here we go to round number three. Bob Sheridan, Lennox Lewis, you're watching King Vision. We're proud to have all our ships at sea and our aircraft carriers and the battle groups and the men on the ground in Kuwait and in the Persian Gulf and all over the world watching tonight, courtesy of Don King. We're thrilled to have you and that you're able to see this fight. This is round three. Jones opens up with a left hook, taken lightly on the gloves by John Ruiz. Ruiz is doing what he did before, and it's Ruiz that's trying to set some sort of a trap, Lennox.
Seems like it. To me, they're both counterpunching. I think Roy Jones is really just picking his shots, waiting.
He is waiting, but, you know, on my scorecard, on very close rounds, both of them, by the way, I gave him to Ruiz just based on I thought he landed heavier blows. That one looked good for the crowd afar, but trying to come with the uppercut, John was able to smother it. Right in the center of the ring. I expected to see Ruiz trying to force this guy back on the rope so he wouldn't be able to move around. And see, John does a nice job making him miss. Part of the reason for that is the reach advantage, too. But a little bit of quickness shown by Ruiz, who considered by the American Network as a plotter. Roy Jones does slide left in the face that time. Ruiz continues to wait. Bangs the body again inside. And Roy feeling the pressure, but, I mean, his body is in magnificent physical condition. Shows his hand speed again with a left foot to the side of the head of Johnny. Then he shows hand speed upstairs. Ruiz continues to wait and doesn't force the pressure like we thought he would with a minute 18 to go in the third round. Jones hasn't opened up at all. He's just picking shots, trying to get that jab in the face of John Ruiz. Ruiz allowing the fight to be fought in the center of the ring, which sort of surprises me. Jones fading and seems to have more confidence now as he tries to get that left through. But there's a heavy shot to the body, and right back with a counterpunch is Roy Jones to the face. And the hand speed's obviously in favor of Jones.
Yeah. Only takes one punch.
Ruiz really digs a hard shot to the body, which is kind of blocked a little bit by Jones, but he felt the power as he walks off more flat-footed this time with 30 seconds to go in the third round. This is another one of these rounds. I tell you, Lennox, it's very close. The uppercut scored that time, and it's scored by Roy Jones Jr. As Jones lands a couple of shots now, and I think he's ahead in this round. Now he's got to finish it strong. 20 seconds to go in the third round, and Jones just outboxing him in this last minute of this round. And that may be enough to give it to the light heavyweight champion of the world.
No, stop!
Yeah, I think this is definitely Roy Jones's round. He's doing a good job. He's definitely throwing the punches that matter at the end.
And sort of dictating, too. And I agree with Lennox Lewis and give that round to Roy Jones Jr.
Okay, listen to me good. This kid ain't coming like he want to now. I want you to go in and steal him, but I need the combination. So the singles and doubles now, let's catch him with the third shot. Let's catch him with the third shot. I want you to try to touch him to the body some, but get low and move out to your right. Okay?
Yeah.
Get low.
All right, watch Ruiz charging with a head down, Lennox. Get the jab thing going, and then he goes to the body. But that's pretty much all he did in the entire course of the fight. Here you are in the end of the round.
Yeah. Well, what you have is a classic, you know, when a guy's fastening you, you try and jab him right up against the ropes and then take advantage of some shots.
Are you surprised, Lennox, that he's not trying to force him to the ropes more?
Yeah, I'm really surprised. Actually, he's trying to box Roy Jones, and he's, you know, a boxer against a boxer, and Roy Jones is a better boxer, a lot quicker.
Yeah, he is, and if Johnny continues to do that, but of course their feeling is that, you know, just drag him into the later rounds, they feel like they can wear him down. But I don't want to give, if I'm in the Ruiz's corner, I don't want to give this Jones any false confidence. But this guy is confident enough as it is. He's a very confident fighter. He's never lost. He didn't know what it's like to lose. Ruiz has gone the distance more often, so we know he can go 12 rounds and be strong. John not forcing him to the ropes, and Roy just picking his shots. Roy paused that time as John comes inside. Roy does a nice job when he comes in on him of getting the hands, the elbows to block the body shots.
Ooh. Roy caught him with a good uppercut there, then ending off with the right.
Ooh. Right hand caught him again. Noticeable hand speed, a big advantage for Jones. Ruiz needs to land a power shot to be taking these rounds, and he needs to land at least one or two every round, because otherwise it's kind of like Chris Bird fighting, you know, the guy touch and get out of there. And that would be ideal if Jones continues to fight that way throughout the course of the fight. It's up to John to force it.
Good move by Roy Jones, twisting him out, staying out of the ropes.
He has tremendous athletic moves like that, and those are the things that he does so well as a boxer that, quite frankly, Johnny Ruiz doesn't do, but doesn't feel he has it during this fight. But right now, he's not winning the rounds. We're halfway through the fourth round, and Roy Jones Jr. is winning this fourth round. And don't forget, the first two rounds, some judges may have given that to Roy Jones, and you get Jones out in front of this fight. Jones right now has a blood trickling from the nose of Johnny Ruiz. He's just out boxing this guy. Johnny not trying to smother the guy. Well, he knows how to tie a guy up when he comes in. John now realizes the blood is coming from his nose. Probably doesn't like that. Roy with a lightning left hand, but he's able to throw from his hip and get it back. Boy, he seems really wide open for the right hand, but John hasn't been able to land a flush shot. Roy knows exactly how to tie him up, and he always tries to sneak off underneath the kind of the shoulder and get behind him and walk behind the referee when he comes out, so he's protected both ways.
Oh, yeah. He's got great skill. He's a seasoned professional.
Yeah, he does things that are so subtle that, you know, you really got to concentrate on what he's doing to realize that, I mean, these aren't accidents. These things are happening so that he can take advantage of every little opportunity that he has in every round. 20 seconds to go in the fourth. In another round that Roy Jones Jr. is up boxing. Johnny, he caught him. It's a pretty good shot. He knows he caught him. Johnny, actually, he buckled his knees.
Oh, he's hurt. He's hurt. Oh, he knows he has him hurt, too.
Yes, he does. He really caught him with a good shot, and he hurt Ruiz. And Ruiz is almost staggering back to his corner. Oh. And Jones stands and watches him.
Roy Jones says he'll be back.
Okay, Hulk, give me the bottle. Water bottle.
He's coming out, Johnny.
Watch this right hand. That hurt him.
Gotta get on him.
That better cut out.
Get on him.
Oh, he just cut him flush with the right hand. And look at him, his legs go totally. He knows how to hang on, but that shows you that Jones can't hurt him. And now is Jones kind of hot-dogging it here.
This is a classic punch, you know, catch a guy when he's coming in. He kind of helps you knock him out. Because he's coming in, the force is coming in with his right hand. They connect.
Well, we're going to the fifth round, and Jones really hurt Johnny Ruiz with that shot. Ruiz on his feet, and he must force this fight now. He's going to just, and he's the type of guy that can do it now. He realizes now time has been called. Let's see. In the corner.
We got too much Vaseline here.
Too much Vaseline on Roy Jones Jr.
Time in.
To wipe it off, and Jay Nady says time back in. Now Jones, if he's going to do anything, he wants to keep the momentum going. So he wants to try to time another one of those right hands. Meanwhile, he's almost lulled Ruiz to sleep. Ruiz has got to put some pressure on him and land some shots of his own. He's got to open it up and try to hurt Roy Jones. Now Jones will take advantage of him, as he did in that last round. Jones is supremely confident right now. He really knows that he can hurt this guy, and so far, Johnny hasn't been able to hurt him at all. Back in the first round, he caught him with a, you know, a fair shot, but you know, Jones has been hit before, and he knows what it's like to be hit. And certainly in his training, he's been hit getting ready for this fight. To this point, Roy Jones Jr.'s boxing skills have been better than Johnny Ruiz. And the only telling blow in the entire fight has been a strong right hand at the tail end of the fourth round by Jones that definitely hurt Ruiz and rocked him. Now Jones digs behind the right elbow. Now he's in the process of giving him kind of a boxing lesson. Smacks Ruiz with left hands that are getting through. Ruiz not able to keep the pressure on him. Jones able to keep him off with his jabs. Go ahead, Lennox.
Right now, it just seems like Ruiz is just following Roy Jones around. That's what Roy Jones basically wants.
It's working ideally. John has his head down when he comes in. Roy has a way of getting his gloves up on top of his head and smothering him, his punches with his elbows. And things are going Roy Jones Jr.'s way right now. He's out boxing, and that's exactly, this is the type of fight that Jones would love to fight the entire 12 rounds. Sneaky uppercut inside, and he caught him with a left hand, and he's kind of surprised Johnny Ruiz with some of his power. Ruiz tapped him with the right hand, and Roy just makes fun of it. Kind of mocking Ruiz. Roy is off on the line and be hot out of here right now, but he's that kind of guy. He's so confident, Lennox. 36 seconds to go in the fifth round. And once again, Jones is beating Ruiz to the punch and outboxing him. Trying to set a trap, as Lennox said, for to catch again Ruiz coming in. Ruiz wags the head. He's just not able to land anything flush. And he can't catch Jones. And Jones now shaping it and kind of showing off for the crowd. Closing seconds now of the fifth round, and that's a Roy Jones Jr. round again as he unboxed Johnny Ruiz. Well, I gave Ruiz very, very slightly the first two rounds, and Roy Jones three, definitely four, and again five.
I want you to work the jab overtime. Work your jab overtime. Work it up and down. Work it up and down. Try to set up a big shot. You counting good? Keep the windshield wiper going though. Keep that windshield wiper going. Okay? All right? Look right here.
Stay sharp. The right hand's gonna come from here and fast. He sees it coming. Throw a shot behind
him. Come on, Johnny. You gotta get in his fight, man. You gotta get in his fight.
Come on. He starts the ropes.
You see Jones able to land shots here and getting just supremely confident as he's landing the shots and outboxing Johnny Ruiz.
Hey, Jack, put some water on the bottle.
Now let's see if Ruiz can do anything to turn this around. You heard Norman Stone say in the corner, hey, John, you're going to get back in this fight. And Norman Stone is right. Roy is super confident right now and just outboxing this guy, giving away some 33 pounds in weight. 7.5 inches in reach, and the reach hasn't showed at all in this fight. If anything, the jab of Jones Jr. is landing much more than John's able to land is. Sneaky right hand that Jones just rolls with a punch.
Doesn't seem like Johnny Ruiz wants to take a chance in there. He needs to go in there and take some chances and try and force this fight. If he has any hope of winning.
Just as he came in that time, Jones is backing off and able to tap him with a nice left hook as he came in. And with every time he does something like that, you can just see the confidence level rise in Roy Jones Jr. He's not exactly the type of guy that needs to have too much confidence. I mean, he's almost a very cocky guy.
Yeah, let's remember, there's still a whole heap of rounds left.
Yeah, we're just in the sixth round. Sneaky right hand lead that time by Jones. Johnny looks very sloppy, but that's the way he fights. He's an awkward sort of guy, always looks awkward. And he's getting outboxed right now by a superior athlete. And there's nobody that ever questioned the boxing ability or the athletic superiority of Roy Jones Jr. And so far, the power of John Ruiz hasn't landed. When it does, make no mistake about it, he can drop this guy. But he hasn't been able to land the flush punch thus far. And we're in the sixth round. And if it goes this way, Jones is just going to outbox him and win under decision. Unless he catches him with another big right hand like he did back in that fourth round. Jones, even when he gets touched up, doesn't let Ruiz know that he's even been hit. Jones waiting, trying to time it as he did in that fourth round. Just a minute to go now in the sixth round. And again, Ruiz has landed more in this round, but I don't know if he's done enough to win this round. Jones waits, tries to set the trap for him, and this is the way he fights. Superb boxing skills with a sneaky right-handed lead. Bounces the head back, and then steps back and admires it. Has both his hands down now. And he's able to get his hands back up as Ruiz comes forward. He seemingly has no respect for the power, and he loads up a nice left hook of his own. Doesn't quite catch John Ruiz by that. John Ruiz's face is a mess, but it's just blood from a nosebleed that started back in the second round. Nice straight left hand that time got the attention of Roy Jones. And he backs off a bit now. I think he felt a little bit of the power, but he didn't show it much. But he goes back on the ropes, and Johnny Ruiz, I don't know if he did enough to steal that round, because, again, most of the ring generalship in that round was by Roy Jones Jr. How do you feel about that round? That's a pretty close round.
Yeah, that was a close round, but I think Roy pulled it out. You know, he didn't get a hit. He went in there, threw some good punches, used his speed.
Now I've got Jones out in front by a couple of rounds as we listen to Ferguson talk to Jones. Look at the confidence in Jones.
Give it here. Give me some deep breaths, champ.
One of the better left hooks by Roy Jones earlier in the round. You see he catches it and just times, and that you were talking about that, and another combination of him by Roy, and you talk about the timing and using the weight, catching John coming in, and Johnny gets a nice left, but that almost in a freaky sort of position his hand was in, so he didn't really get the heaviness of the punch there.
And that's the only thing he's really hitting him with, nothing else. He needs to hit him with that right hand if he really wants to win this fight.
But we're halfway through the fight, and Roy Jones Jr., my scorecard, which is unofficial, is out in front by 2 points. Johnny Ruiz was hurt in the tail end of the fourth round by a vicious right hand thrown by Roy Jones Jr. And so far, Ruiz's power has not shown at all. Roy Jones has been able to gobble everything up. The left hook, wide with the right uppercut. And Jones has things going pretty much his way to this point. But as Lennox said, there's a lot of time to go yet. And a lot of the boxing people think that perhaps Jones would wear down in the later rounds, but he's in such superb condition. Unless he's hit by a right hand, you're not going to wear down Lennox. I mean, you're going to wear this guy out. Look at the body on him.
He's in tremendous shape, no doubt.
And here's a guy that had to actually put weight on and build up to the 190-pound level that he weighed in about tonight. Actually, he weighed over 190. He got all the way up to 199 tonight earlier. Approaching 200, but it's still 30 pounds different. But that's not the factor in the fight. He's outboxing this guy and continues to outbox him. John gets a left jab through, but it doesn't hurt Jones. There's the right hands that he needs to throw. But you know something, Lennox? He doesn't seem to be going head-hunting with the right hand. He comes in, Jones is able to tie up his hands, and then he throws to the body.
That's good discipline.
All right, no. Thank you.
That time, Jones didn't do what he's done before. Instead of walking around after getting hooked by the elbow, he came back out in front, which shows me more confidence. Pulls that left hand down, throws the right hand behind it. He misses John. Ruiz standing right in front of him, continues to prod and wait, wait, and wait. Jones huffing and puffing a little bit, but he's certainly in total control. And this is what he does. He sets the trap again, and he nailed him with another right hand. And Jones is like at a Sunday tea party. Just smiles over the press row. Looks over. Just tries to antagonize John Ruiz, and Ruiz continues to wait. And I don't understand this style at all for John Ruiz waiting. He gets countered with a low blow as he comes in. Ruiz continues to wait, and this is perfect for Roy Jones because Roy sets his trap. He's just waiting for him to come in. Jones swinging that left hand in front of Ruiz, but Ruiz continues to wait. Now he comes in, tries to throw a right hand, but again it's downstairs and not upstairs with 22 seconds to go in the seventh. It's Roy Jones Jr. waiting, landing the flurries when he has to, and outboxing John Ruiz. If his game plan is to try to outbox this guy, he made a serious mistake here, Lennox. Big right hand gets through again. John throws a few shots, but he doesn't hurt Jones at all. And here's the bell, ending the seventh round, and Jones is outboxed him in the seventh.
There we go.
Is Roy just beating him to the punch, Lennox? And this is the way the fight has gone since the third round on. Look at him with a sneaky right-hand lead. Johnny loves to roughhouse it on the inside, but he did not success.
You gotta fucking do it. You gotta do this. Fucking Roy is doing everything, man. Come on.
You gotta go to the game plan. What's the problem? Tell me. Get in there with that jab and walk him down. And throw the other punches, throw your combinations. Can we keep your hands up? Throw the chin.
Knock him down, gentlemen.
Come on now, get working, get busy.
Okay, bye.
Well, there's a definite concern, Lennox, in the corner of John Ruiz. They know he's losing the fight.
Oh, yeah, he needs to get it going if he wants to be good in this fight. Roy's not easy to hit, I always said. You know, well, guys in his own weight class can't hit him. Now, the heavyweights, you know, he's just moving a step faster.
Now here's John trying to dig to the body. Roy covers himself up. Johnny trying to keep pressure on him. He's working hard now. But Roy just has a way of just, you know, defending himself so well. And he comes off the rope right back. And now they exchange punches. And here's Jones now that wants to swap punches with John Ruiz. You look at Roy Jones. He didn't look like he was hurt at all in that exchange. Yet people said he never should stand in there and try to mix with him. But he picks his time, Lennox.
Definitely does.
I'll tell you this, he got Jones' attention because Jones is not hot-dogging it right now, and he has a more concerned look in his eye. But Johnny's got to get the pressure right now if he's going to do this. Roy just a superb boxer. And then his John back to his old style, waiting, waiting, and waiting. Now Jones has got all his wind back. He feels strong again. Got that confident look, almost swaggering around in the ring. We're in the eighth round. Nice counterpunch that time by John Ruiz.
Just missed.
Johnny having his best round since the second round of the fight, but he needs it badly because Roy Jones Jr. won 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 on my scorecard, and if the judges are close to that, he's way out in front in this fight. Now Ruiz comes back, not able to catch him that time with Jones. Jones lightning fast with the left of the face of Johnny Ruiz. Now he waits, tries to set that trap again. But Ruiz, instead of smothering him, is waiting, waiting, waiting. And this is not the style if John Ruiz is going to win this fight. He's got to get on him like he did in the first few seconds of the round. Minute 9 seconds ago in the eighth round. Ruiz can win this round, but Jones can also win it. Jones back at his heels as he waits for John to come in. Now John tries to get on him, and then it goes right back to what you said, Lennox. This guy is really tough to hit. As Jones and a couple more of those shots is going to take this round back from Johnny Ruiz. After Ruiz apparently was going to win this round, there's still 45 seconds to go. And Jones with another flurry and maybe another right hand can win this round and steal the round away from John Ruiz. Nice right hand, get through and get Ruiz's attention. Boy, he shows lightning fast reflexes, doesn't he?
Oh, yeah, very quick. Like I said, he reminds me of a snake. It's 1 second he's there, Johnny Ruiz throws a punch and he's gone.
Hey, Roy Jones Jr. really, really impressing me tonight, I'll tell you that. This is a terrific effort for a light heavyweight who at one time was a middleweight, super middleweight champ. Ruiz may have done enough to get this round as he keeps the pressure on in these last few seconds. It's important that he impresses the judges to try and steal this round. I think he may have won that round. I don't know, Lennox. What do you see?
I may have won, dude. It looked even to me.
Well, if he won any of the last 5 or 6 rounds, he won that one. I don't know if the judges are going to see it that way. But it was all in the first minute of the round, and then Roy went right back to boxing.
Yes.
You got to pick it up, Johnny. You hear me? The ninth round, baby. We got 3 more rounds. You got to go out there and fight, kid. Come on now. Pick it up now. We're not in the bullshit now. Come on.
As Johnny, you know, tries to get the pressure on, but notice he never really gets him with a clean shot, only that one left hook really did any damage at all, and then Roy Jones Jr. comes right back. You know, and look at him, he catches it with a nice uppercut, then they trade punches a little bit here. You know, you can feel it. John Jones like, man, I can't wait to land the shot. You almost want to throw it for him.
Johnny wants to mix it up. He wants to get in there and fight. He wants to trade punches. He doesn't like this cat and mouse game.
No, he doesn't, but that's Roy Jones's expertise, and if he's got that for fight plan, he's executed it to near perfection tonight. We're in the ninth round. I'm Bob Sheridan. With me is Lennox Lewis, the heavyweight champion of the world. With all due respect to the reigning champ, Johnny Ruiz, how much longer his reign is going to last will be told over the next few minutes. And Chris Bird, who may take exception to that, but Lennox Lewis, universally known as the emperor of the heavyweight division. This is the ninth round. We're in Las Vegas. Roy Jones Jr. has outboxed John Ruiz through 8 rounds. Superbly confident, showing his speed, dictating the flow of the fight, landing shots when he wants to. Able to block the power of John Ruiz for the most part. I've given John Ruiz 3 rounds in my scorecard, but every one of them, I question whether the judges will give him those rounds. That's how well Roy Jones Jr. has boxed in this fight. Jones up on his toes as he circles around to the left, gets in position, tries to set the trap again, and John Ruiz is going for it. He just stays off, instead of pressuring him with throwing right hands. He doesn't even have the left jab pumping in the face of Jones Jr. And when he does, it's down at his chest. He's just touching him. Johnny right now needs to land a big right hand, and he better land it soon because Jones Jr. just beat him with a nice stiff left jab to the face. Roy bounces off the rope, circles around to his right, totally dictating the flow of each and every round of the fight. Jones showing what a supreme, superbly conditioned athlete he is. And he has answered all questions in terms of his readiness for this fight. But the one great thing about the heavyweight division, and Lennox, you know this, it can come at any time like a bolt out of the blue.
That's true.
Just when you think everything's nice and quiet and nicely going your way, it can happen.
You know, right now it seems like Roy Jones is just baiting him right now. He throws a jab and he walks away. Sometimes he throws a jab and not even looking and hits Johnny Ruiz.
Even in the clinches, though, Roy seems to know how to tie up the power hand, the right hand. He's got his arm over the right hand of Ruiz, and Ruiz has to be satisfied with trying to flail away with the left hand inside. Jones is doing a nice job tying him up, and see how quick he is. He's in there, bends down, gets out of there, gets himself back in position, and just beating Ruiz to the punch with a left in the face all the time. Nobody has been down, but John Ruiz was staggered back in the tail end of the fourth round. And the heavier blows, believe it or not, have been landed by Roy Jones Jr. as opposed to the heavyweight, Johnny Ruiz. And this is just exactly the type of fight that Roy Jones wants it to go, exactly this way. He's having everything his way. And again, I think that he just dictated the flow of this round, and I think Roy Jones outboxed John Ruiz in the ninth round. ...87-84 my scorecard, giving Jones that last round with three rounds to go. Ruiz is getting to the point where he's got to knock him down and maybe knock him out if he's going to win this fight.
Put him together for me a little bit this round. You winning them with them singles, but put them together for me. All right? All right. Ready to go.
Tighten your head up when he grabs
you. Pulling back. You hear me? Yeah, Jeff, step with the right hand.
Referee's completely wrong. Completely.
Come on now, pick it up.
Come on, Johnny. Make it a
fight. Make it a fight.
I got money on you. Come on, Johnny.
Make it a fight. Make it a fight.
I heard Norman Stone say the referee's wrong. I didn't catch what that problem was at all.
I didn't catch that one either.
I don't know either, but whatever it is, it's a distraction because it has nothing to do with the referee. Johnny Ruiz has got to keep pressure on this guy, and this far through the fight, we're in the 10th round now, he hasn't been able to do it. He's got to do what great champions do if he's going to be the great champion tonight, and that's close out this show. Roy Jones Jr. up at his toes, bouncing left, back to his right. Jets out with that left hand in the face of Ruiz. Ruiz seemingly wants to get to him, but he continues to wait, trying to back him up against the ropes. Jones continues to back up, waiting, trying to bait, use his hand speed. John bangs to the body again. Why doesn't he come upstairs?
Doesn't have time to. That time Roy got warned by the referee for holding and hitting at the same time.
Now he got him with a pretty good left hook that time, just enough to hold him off. All he has to do is touch this guy, and he gets him to stop in his tracks and holds him off just enough so he can feint to the right and then get out of there to the left and then touch him up every time. And all he's doing is outboxing, and what's happened is Roy Jones has got this guy in a boxing match. Now he tries to load up and try to side, and he bangs Jones. Jones sitting on the ropes, and this is where Ruiz wants to fight this fight, right here. They'd love to keep Jones there. And there is a certain fatigue factor, and they said, at least the people you talked to, Lennox, you can tell me better than this, the smaller guy at this stage should be wilting a little bit from the pressure of a heavy guy, but John Ruiz really hasn't put the pressure on him.
Hasn't caught him with any sound shots to really slow him down. So, you know, he can still move at his normal pace. In fact, Johnny Ruiz has slowed down quite a lot.
Now he has, and you know, he really hasn't looked like himself from the get-go and from the reaction of the corner. I mean, they sense something wrong almost immediately by the second round of the fight that John's not executing whatever their fight plan was. It isn't this.
You know, styles make fights. This is a classic style matchup. And, you know, Johnny Ruiz can't figure it out, hasn't found the ticket to it yet, hasn't found the lock to it, hasn't found the key to it.
Roy Jones hits him on the, kind of on the hip and then smiles. And the crowd, of course, gets the reaction. But just that cocky look in the face. I'm fighting a guy like Jones. I want to kill him. And the frustrating thing, you as a fighter know this, when you have one of those nights where things aren't going, although you haven't had too many nights that haven't gone your way, when things aren't going your way at different times in a fight, it's very, very frustrating for a competitive fighter. Nice combination again by Roy Jones.
It's very draining as well. You know, all of a sudden, a guy hits you. You try and hit him and you miss and he smiles at you. It's very draining for you mentally.
Very draining mentally, and that's from Lennox Lewis, who should know. And right now I can see the drain on John Ruiz because Roy Jones Jr. is doing a terrific job out boxing him here. Ruiz tries and he continues to bang the body, tries to set him up to the head, but he doesn't throw a shot to the head. Now he comes in. Johnny seems like he really wants to pick the pace up, but he can't land that shot. Instead, he's outboxed by Roy Jones. I gotta say, even though John was more aggressive in that round, he still, I don't think he won the round. I don't know. How do you feel, Lenny?
You know, Roy didn't really do too much that round. He basically rested to me. You know, I think he's saving it for these two more rounds. That's 6 minutes in the mind of a boxer, so, you know.
So you'd go the other way and give that round actually to, in this particular case, you would give that round to John Ruiz?
Yeah, definitely, because Roy didn't really do too much. He looked like he just rested. I believe in this next couple rounds, Roy's going to get it started again.
So with two rounds to go, then, if we go with Johnny Ruiz in that last round, Lennox, I've got 3 points in favor for Roy Jones Jr., which means we need a knockout or at least a knockdown.
Yes.
All right, the comments of this man, he should know. Johnny really tried to get him on the ropes. He landed a glancing blow, but nothing really there. So with a couple of rounds to go, if you give that 10th round to Ruiz and Ruiz got the 8th round, then, you know, the fight is maybe within a couple of 3 points of each other. But, I mean, when you watch the fight, it's clearly a situation where Roy Jones Jr. has just outboxed this guy. And whether it's 1, 2, or 3, or 4 points one way or the other, Jones has just outboxed the guy. And therefore, I mean, after 10 rounds, you're going to say Jones wins the fight. But this is a 12-round championship fight, and Ruiz must try to pressure him. He's going to win this and retain his heavyweight title. Otherwise, Jones is about to become one of the most famous men on the planet.
In fact, at this point, I think he needs to knock Roy Jones out.
I would certainly agree with that, with the point differential I have on my scorecard. And doing it like this is going to work. But as you know, and we continue to tell our viewing audience, one punch in the heavyweight division can change the course in a hurry. But does John have that one punch in his arsenal? Because he hasn't been able to land a flush punch yet, really. Not a flush punch. The only really, really heavy flush punch during the course of the fight was landed by Roy Jones Jr. back in the 4th round when he staggered John Ruiz. And if nothing more, I mean, he's outboxed Ruiz and he staggered him. He's the winner. Loads up the left hand, which catches him. Sneaky right hand, just superbly outboxing him. Now he backs Ruiz back on his heels. I'll tell you this, he's really got to pick it up because Jones is making him look bad right now. And as you mentioned, there's a fatigue factor for the heavyweight too here. I mean, he's worked very hard with this guy, chasing him around the whole night. And it hasn't been the situation where he's just chased him around blindly all night. Jones has set traps for him. He waited, waited, waited. He showed patience. It was just a great skilled boxer.
Oh, yeah. Definitely deals with the sweet science of the sport.
Not particularly, you know, a crowd-pleasing fight, but if you're a boxing aficionado, you've got to love the skill of Roy Jones Jr., who's just really shown up a big heavyweight here.
Absolutely.
And John Ruiz in the process of losing the WBA heavyweight championship, unless something very dramatic happens in the last 38 seconds of this round or the 3 minutes remaining in the fight. And Jones doing what he's been doing throughout, digging to the body, coming upstairs, beating into the punch throughout. Wow, with the left hand is Jones that time. Johnny trying to hunt him down. Gets him up against the ropes, but again, the lack of the ability to hurt him upstairs. Closing seconds of the 11th round. And now it will take a knockout for John Ruiz to win this fight. The only way he can win this fight now, Lennox, is via the knockout rule. I got a 106-103, and that might be very conservative, giving a lot of breaks to John Ruiz.
Come on, give some water over there. Come on.
I would be surprised if the judges have it anywhere near as close as I have it. I've just looked for opportunities to give some rounds that were halfway decent for Ruiz to him if there were any rounds given to him. There may be a 6-point differential in this scoring right here. But definitely, would you agree with me that the only way that Johnny Ruiz can win this fight is to knock him out now?
Absolutely. I mean, Johnny Ruiz definitely has to go in there, try and knock him out. This is the only way he's going to win this fight at this point. You know, Roy Jones basically doesn't have to mix it up at this point. He can just dance around the ring and win this fight.
Would you fight Roy Jones, Jr.? If the money were right?
If the money was right, definitely.
The words of Lennox Lewis. The 12th and final round. All Roy Jones Jr. has to do is stay away from this guy and he'll get the decision. And that's what he's going to try to do. He has a great ability to be able to tie this guy up when he comes inside by grabbing him by the ears and holding his head up. And I'll tell you this, Ruiz can't afford to wait even 2 or 3 seconds. He's got to get on top of this guy and try to hurt him, something he hasn't been able to do throughout the course of the fight. And Johnny Ruiz is going to lose the title unless he catches him with a big right hand and catches him in a hurry. He's out of time. And the only way he can win is by the knockout. And Roy Jones just loves it. It's like a day at the office for him, showing a total lack of respect for the heavyweight champion, whose reign is in the minutes now. The 12th and final round of the fight. Lennox, it'll be pandemonium when this thing's over, so in case you sneak out of here or anything, I want to thank you for being with us, and you did a superb job again, and I hope we have the opportunity to work together again, but hang in here till we get the decision anyway. I got a couple questions I got to ask you about the future of this division.
That's no problem.
All right. Ruiz bangs him to the body. Time is a factor now, and for the WBA champ who's about to be the WBA former heavyweight champion of the world, time is ticking away. Less than a minute and a half to go in the fight, and Roy Jones Jr. has been confident throughout, up on the toes, smiling and taunting the WBA champ at times. And all he has to do is exactly what he's doing now. Stay up on the toes, stay away. He can even let John outbox him in this, as long as he doesn't get caught by a big shot. He's smiling, looking out to the crowd, absolutely no concern and a total lack of respect for John Ruiz. And Ruiz has allowed him to do it. Lennox?
I think Roy Jones realizes he's won this fight. He's going to probably do a little showboating right now in the last 50 seconds. I think he's still trying to catch John Ruiz coming in with that right hand. He would love to end it on that note.
Oh, he'd love to be able to time one and catch him and knock him down to make it definitive. It's definitive enough as far as I'm concerned. With just about a little over 30 seconds to go in the fight, Roy Jones Jr. has done what nobody since Michael Spinks has done and what no middleweight former middleweight champion has done in over 100 years. And the crowd is beginning to stand on its feet for Roy Jones Jr. It's evident that Roy Jones Jr. has outboxed the heavyweight champion of the world, and Roy Jones is about to become the WBA heavyweight champion. He's done it. He's done it what no other middleweight champion has done. And now the fight's all over, and he knows it. I got a 116-112, but I think the judges will have it a lot more further apart than that. Lennox, just a couple of quick questions, because everybody wants to talk to you here. Mike Tyson, will you fight him in June? Is that what you're trying to work on?
You know, me and Mike Tyson, when we signed for the first fight, we signed for 2 fights straight away. But,
right.
You know, Mike Tyson says he doesn't want to fight him. But, you know, we're going to have to see what happens down the line.
You're negotiating, I know, with HBO this weekend. That's what Russ Friedberg told me. What are you negotiating for?
Well, we're going to see what happens. And,
so you're not going to give me any information?
No definitive answer right now.
Well, I'll tell you this. You've avoided all my questions like Roy Jones avoided the heavy punch from John Ruiz tonight. Lennox, a great pleasure having you with me. Enjoyed it.
Thanks for having me.
All right.
I'd like Lennox to pick up my friends down at Caesar Keys.
All right. They want you to hang in here because they want to put us on camera for a second after the decision for one final comment. I think it's academic, but we'll wait. Again, I scored at 116-112 in favor of Roy Jones Jr. There's no question in my mind that Roy Jones has won this fight.
Oh, yeah. He did a phenomenal job. Like I said, you know, he doesn't get hit. He's not going to get hit. Boxing a heavyweight is just too quick.
You know, when they talked about all the other guys, some of the heavyweights that Bob Foster was a tremendous puncher, was a light heavyweight. He wasn't the skilled boxer that Roy Jones Jr. is, and he was up against heavy punchers like, for instance, Joe Frazier, who was a much better banger and probably a better boxer than John Ruiz.
Yes.
Wait, what, where does Johnny Ruiz go now?
Rematch, probably a rematch, you know. Probably he feels that he could beat Roy Jones the next fight.
Well, you know what it's like. You were surprised a couple of times by Oliver McCall and Haseem Rockman, and you certainly avenged both of those, but God, it must feel awful to lose the heavyweight championship of the world.
Nobody likes to lose. Everybody's going in there, they're feeling confident. They don't have losing on their mind. But when it happens, you know, it's always disappointing. And one thing you have to realize, you know, two boxers go in the ring. It has to be a loser.
That's it. All right, here's Jimmy Lennon.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing, the judges are in agreement. We have a unanimous decision. Here are the score totals. Judge at ringside, Jerry Roth scores the bout 116 to 112. Dwayne Ford scores the bout 117 to 111. Judge Stanley Christodoulou sees the bout 118 to 110. All three in favor of the winner, joining boxing's elite, the new WBA heavyweight champion of the world, Roy Jones Jr.
There he is, the brand new WBA heavyweight champion of the world. And now, with me as Lennox Lewis, as we get ready to close out the show, it's anybody's guess as to what Roy Jones Jr. will do. He's got a contract now to go to China and teach the Chinese to fight.
Oh, wow. Well, I'm telling you, Roy Jones can beat a lot of heavyweights out there. So, you know, I'm sure if the money's right, you know, he's definitely going to go back in there against a heavyweight, because this is his highest person in his whole life, in his whole career. So he's definitely going to go back in there and try and beat another heavyweight.
Well, one place he'll go before that is he's going to the bank on Monday morning with a check with $10 million, and that's a huge payday for this guy. It's the biggest one of his career, and he continues to celebrate, and he's just absolutely thrilled to be the new champion of the world. A tremendous victory.